So I would say a policy, a foreign policy that takes care of our national defense, that we're willing to get along with people and trade with people as the founders advised. There's no authority in the Constitution to be the policeman of the world and no nation building. Just remember, George Bush won the presidency on that platform in the year 2000. And I still think it's a good...
Should the people of the world look at the United States, Governor, and say, should they fear us? Should they welcome our involvement? Should they see us as a friend, everybody in the world? How would you project us around the world as president?
Yeah, I'm not so sure the role of the United States is to go around the world and say, this is the way it's got to be. So I'm not exactly sure where the vice president is coming from, but I think one way for us to end up being viewed as the ugly American is for us to go around the world saying, we do it this way, so should you. I just don't think it's the role of the United States to walk into a country and say, we do it this way, so should you. It really depends upon how our nation conducts itself in foreign policy. If we're an arrogant nation, they'll resent us. If we're a humble nation but strong, they'll welcome us. And our nation stands alone right now in the world in terms of power. And that's why we've got to be humble. If we're an arrogant nation, they'll view us that way, but if we're a humble nation, they'll respect us. Maybe I misunderstand where you're coming from, Mr. Vice President, but I think the United States must be humble and must be proud and confident of our values, but humble in how we treat nations that are figuring out how to chart their own course.
Make a couple
sure,
of comments.
Sure, absolutely, sure. Somalia started off as a humanitarian mission and then changed into a nation-building mission, and that's where the mission went wrong. The mission was changed. And as a result, our nation paid a price. And so I don't think our troops ought to be used for what's called nation building. You mentioned Haiti. I wouldn't have sent troops to Haiti. I didn't think it was a mission worthwhile. It was a nation building mission. I think what we need to do is convince people who live in the lands they live in to build the nations. Maybe I'm missing something here. I mean, we're going to have kind of a nation building corps from America. One of the problems we have in the military is we're in a lot of places around the world. And I mentioned one, and that's the Balkans. I'd very much like to get our troops out of there.
If we don't stop extending our troops all around the world in nation building missions, then we're going to have a serious problem coming down the road, and I'm going to prevent that.
I'm concerned that we're over-deployed around the world.
I don't want to be the world's policeman. I want to be the world's peacemaker.
Your question was deployment. The force must be strong enough so that the mission can be accomplished, and the exit strategy needs to be well defined. A lot of people are sick and tired of the bitterness in Washington, D.C., and therefore they don't want any part of politics. They look at Washington and see people pointing fingers and casting blame and saying one thing and doing another. It needs somebody in office who will tell the truth. That's the best way to get people back in the system.